The function f is given by f of x is equal to e to the power x over 1 plus kx, where k is a constant, positive constant, and prove that f of x has a point of inflection as that x is equal to 1 over 2k squared minus 1 over k. Okay, now for this question, I want to discuss the quotient rule. The quotient rule is like this, f over g dash, if you want to find the derivation or differentiation of f divided by g, the quotient rule says this is f dash times g minus f times g dash over g squared. Okay, so this is basically come from the product rule. So this is the formula which is would be there in your formula sheet. Now this question I have taken from a calculus paper of NZQA. This is at New Zealand, and the name of the standard is differentiate function and use derivative to solve problem. So this is one thing that you should be knowing. And the second thing is, at point of inflection, at P or I in short, your f double dash would be zero. Okay, your second derivative is zero at the point of inflection. Or point of inflection is a point where the curve changes the concavity. Okay. So your function is f of x is equal to e to the power x over 1 plus kx. So basically this question is a question of finding the second derivative. Okay, now if f of x is e to the power ax, using chain rule, this implies f dash x. Using the chain rule, differentiate the inside, so it's a e to the power ax. So this is a formula you should be knowing. So I'm going to basically use this formula and this formula and also this to get this result. Okay, so your f dash x, so let me again write f of x is e to the power x over x over 1 plus kx. 1 plus kx. Okay. Here a, I hope you know, is the differentiation of ax. If you differentiate ax, you get a. And that's why you write a. And this is a chain rule. So basically, you can also write the same thing as, this is same as writing e to the power ax is e to the power ax times a, which is the gradient of or differentiation of this. The differentiation of this gives you this. So using the same rule, I can say e to the power x over 1 plus kx would be e to the power x over 1 plus kx. And I have to differentiate this function. To differentiate this, I'm going to use the quotient rule. So using the quotient rule, this is your f and this is your g. So it is f dash, so the differentiation of x is 1 times the denominator, which is 1 plus kx. So let me write this in a big bracket. Minus f is your x, times your denominator, which is the gradient of the denominator is k. The differentiation of 1 plus kx is k over 1 plus kx the whole squared, where 1 plus kx is your g. Okay, so this simplifies to e to the power x over 1 plus kx, okay, times, if you open this bracket, this is 1 plus kx minus kx, which is nothing but 1 over 1 plus kx the whole squared. Okay, so this implies, you can say f dash x of this function is that same thing, e to the power x over 1 plus kx, 1 plus kx over 1 plus kx the whole squared. So again, this you can consider as your f and this is your g. Okay, so now let me change color. So now f double dash x. So now your f is, this is your f, this is your f, and this is your g. So using again the quotient rule, differentiate f, which is the original function, that will give you this. So that would be e to the power x over 1 plus kx over this whole thing, which is 1 plus kx, 1 plus kx the whole square. This is the gradient, this is f dash times your denominator. Your denominator is 1 plus kx the whole squared minus the denominator, no, the numerator, which is e to the power, your f is x over 1 plus kx times the differentiation of the denominator, which is g dash. So using the chain rule, this will be k times 2 times 1 plus kx to the power 1, the whole thing is squared, this g squared. So this will be 1 plus kx squared, the whole squared. So this is again the quotient rule. So let's simplify this. So what will happen? This and this gets cancelled. 1 plus kx the whole squared, 1 plus kx squared the whole squared will be cancelled. So this will become much neater now. So f double dash x is e to the power x over 1 plus kx, 1 plus kx e to the power x over 1 plus kx minus, this you simplify to 2k times e to the power x over 1 plus kx times 1 plus kx over 1 plus kx the whole raised to 4. Okay, and that I'm going to set equal to 0, because at point of inflection, you can say at point of inflection, this f dash, f double dash is going to be equal to 0. Now, if you cross multiply, this whole thing will disappear in the next step. In the next step, you can't see this because I'm multiplying both sides by 1 plus kx to the power 4, or cross multiplying. This will disappear, and you can say e to the power x over 1 plus kx minus 2k times e to the power x over 1 plus kx times 1 plus kx is equal to 0. Okay, so you can factor out e to the power x over 1 plus kx times 1 minus 2k times 1 plus kx is equal to 0. So now this implies this is a quadratic function. This has become a product of two expressions. So this times this is 0. So you can say e to the power x over 1 plus kx is equal to 0. Now e is a number, e is a constant, 2.7 something. And you raise it to any number, positive or negative, this is never going to be 0. So you can say this is never going, this is not possible. Mathematically, this is never possible because e is a constant, is a positive constant, or any number raised to any power cannot ever be 0. It's always greater than 0. Okay, so this is always going to be greater than 0. So this means you can say set this equal to 0. So this implies you can say 1 minus 2k times 1 plus kx is equal to 0. Now moving this to the other side, you can say 1 is equal to 2k times 1 plus kx. So this is 1 equal to 2kx. 1 is equal to 2k plus 2k squared x. Okay, so what can we do now? Okay, so this I can, okay, I don't need to do this step, so what can we do? Now you can we do this as 1 over 2k? 1 over 2k is equal to, dividing both sides by 2k is equal to 1 plus kx. Okay, so I'm going to isolate the k, so this is 1 over 2k minus 1 over 1 is equal to kx. Okay, now I want to cancel this k, so I'm going to divide the whole thing by k. So this is 1 over 2k squared minus 1 over k. Okay, oh, this step you'll not understand. I'm going to multiply both sides by, I'm going to multiply both sides by 1 over k. If you multiply this side by 1 over k, you can also multiply this side by 1 over k. So the k's gets cancelled. Okay, so what is remaining? This is, and now expanding this out, this is 1 over 2k squared minus 1 over k is equal to x. And that's what we wanted, that you get the point of inflection when x is equal to 1 over 2k squared minus k. And that's what we wanted, that the point of inflection is at this point.